Hello everyone, and welcome to the Ratchet & Clank Collection. Now, I actually played this game like a summer or two back, and admittedly, most of the files I'm pretty sure were unable to be uploaded properly. So, I have taken it upon myself to re-record this, and it'll bring back so many good memories, because I remember when I used to play this all the time during the summer. Ah, those good memories. And as of yet, I obviously still do not have anything to record with high definition, mostly because A, having to record constantly from my phone only to have like 7 gigabytes worth of like, I don't know, like 20-40 minutes of video just isn't enough. Call me greedy, but the process of having to transfer the files can get very tiring very fast. So, you know, it's a lot better if I just go with a lot of space but very low qual. I mean, it's not about the quality of the game that matters, it's about how much fun I have doing it. So, without further ado, let us begin. Let's go to option first. Sound. I also have a new Tomy controller, but I'm not exactly sure if it's really worth it. I say it is, really, but... I don't know. Wow, the last time I played this was 2016. Wow. The memories of it all. Wait. Okay, hold on. Alright, we good. Sorry, that second one. So yeah, this was played in on the 1st of August in 2016. Ah, the memories.
System. Thank you for using Help Desk technology.
Thank you.
So, we're finally playing the game. Hang on. How do I look around? I guess the camera handles that for me. I forgot about that. This brings back so many good memories. The glove bomb. I don't think I ever even completed this game because it says I spent 9 hours on it, or last time I played it was 9 o'clock. Or maybe I did, because I don't know, I just had this incomplete. There we go. Sound. That's better. Okay, I'm turning that off. Okay, maybe I'll leave the text on. That's nanotech. Whenever you sustain injury, let gadgetrons and patented nanotech system rebuild your body from the inside out. So, kind of like the nanomites from Doctor Who. Except they're better and they don't like think that the first thing they find is what everyone else should look like. Like a pro! Like a pro! What I really like about this game is how a lot of the enemies use the same technology you're going to be using later on. Like that, the electric thing they were using, if I recall, that's for the Tesla Claw. So you'll pretty much be giving them a taste of their own medicine, which I really like. It's like, now it's time to see how you like being zapped to death. Yeah, you don't like it that much, do you? Oh, it feels so satisfying to play this game again. I love it. I love every second of it. This is like one of my favorite like PS3 games. I love it. And there's a wreckage over there. Let's go take a look at that. Oh, one other thing. Yeah, I'm gonna need to have like a really fast rotation because that's how I prefer it. I don't want to have to spend like spend like 3 seconds waiting for the camera to change to a slight angle. Your range sucks. Mine doesn't. Booyah! Booyah! I like how you can destroy enemies semi-off-screen too. Oh, I can double tap the right analog stick to throw bombs too. Well, that's that's very handy.
Assistance in saving the solar system. Do you know where I might find that fellow?
Well, he's on the radio everywhere. Other than that, no. Hey, what's with all this save the solar system stuff anyway?
Hello, Citizen Zone. My race, the Blog, had a small problem. Our planet has become so polluted, overpopulated, and poisonous that we are no longer able to dwell here. But I, Chairman Dreg, have a solution. We are constructing a pristine new world using the choicest planetary components available. So, what does this mean to you, you might ask? Using highly sophisticated technology, which you couldn't possibly understand, we will be extracting a large portion of your planet and adding it to our new one. Unfortunately, this change in mass will cause your planet to spin out of control and drift into the sun, where it will explode into a flaming ball of gas, but, of course, sacrifices must be made. Thank you for your cooperation. And if you don't come back, you can take your whiny, sniveling, snot-nosed populations, form a line behind me, and kiss my... Still on? Well, turn it off, you idiot!
The people on those planets are hoes. Well, good luck getting Captain Quark to help you.
Actually, you could help me. If you could use your ship to take me to the coordinates contained in this info pod, I might be able to gather further information there.
Even if I wanted to, I can't. I'm missing a crucial component of the ship.
Robotic ignitions. With the latest in robotic ignition systems. My programming allows me to start any ship I choose.
So, I agree to take you to this wherever it is. Can you get my ship started for me?
That is what I am proposing.
This could be a problem. Take care of it.
Whoa, this is great! So that's where I've been stuck this whole time.
Please return your appendages to the steering mechanism, sir.
Huh? Oh, right. Sorry. Oh, and by the way, you can stop calling me sir. The name's Ratchet.
Pleased to make your acquaintance, sir.
You got a name?
My serial number is 354296.
Oops. I'll just call you Clank for short. Hang on.
So you see, it would be most beneficial if your citizens were not in the city when my workers begin.
Preposterous! I will not stand for this.
Unfortunately, you have no choice in the matter.
Let's just see what Captain Quark has to say about that, my good man. You don't see what's so funny. Captain Quark could dispatch you without even breaking a sweat, you beauty.
You have now officially worn out your welcome and my patience.
This is your last chance. Stop this madness now!
Okay, wait. You're right. I will withdraw my troops.
Really?
No. It's all yours, gentlemen. Try not to leave any marks.
Thank you.
Okay, so if I press the right analog stick downward, I jump. That's a little strange. How do I use this? Nope. Alright. Here we go.
I got some great bargains for you.
I could use some ammo. Let me try to get the hang of this. Okay. So the both right triggers let me crouch. Both left triggers pull up that camera. Good to know. It's gonna take a bit for me to get used to having an actual auto-moving camera. These inhabitants aren't very friendly. This bomb glove is handy. It takes quite a bit for me to get the hang of, though. Although I do like how they automatically target enemies you might want to hit. That's actually rather nice, so you don't have to like spend too much work trying to aim and you get hit in the process. They're like, here, let's take care of that. And they just automatically aim that to the nearest enemy. I like that. I forgot this game has so many great qualities, which is a shame because I love this game. So I don't know how I forgot about them. I mean, then again, it has been 2 years, so can you really blame me for not remembering everything? Are you lucky little punk? I almost got you. Did that guy behind him just kill him? That was great. Now, if I remember correctly, I cannot do anything with this yet. Your range kind of sucks, man. But I guess that's what happens when you get enemies that are at the beginning of the game. Although I do like how they're not like they're not typically easy to beat, and how they look and act a little tough. So the game's taking itself rather seriously. I don't know how I didn't kill you. Now, I do plan on getting every collectible in the game, like I did last time. So, don't worry about that. Yeah, like that's gonna deter me. That's gonna deter me all that much. The one thing I remember is fighting Courtney Gears and continuously dying just so I could upgrade my weapons. That I remember so well. In the middle of the night. I'm most likely going to be saving up all of my little, all my screws until, unless I absolutely have to spend them. Oh, hello. You know, you guys aren't very menacing, especially in numbers. Like, I can just take you out easily. Like, no problem.
Torturers? Assassins? I'll tell you anything. Here, take my info box. It's all I've got left.
Sir, you're not assassins.
Hold on. Let's see what he's got.
Has this ever happened to you? Hi, I'm Captain Quark, and believe me, there's nothing worse than staring down a Blargian Snagglebeast from the inside, and knowing your equipment isn't functioning properly. That's why I come to Al's Robo Shack for all my electronic needs. Al has been the exclusive repair shop for my super electro gadgets since I was knee-high to a sand mouse. If Al can't fix it, it's not broke. Right, Al? You said it, pal. So if you're fighting crime, or just fighting grime, come to Al's Robo Shack in Metropolis for all your robotic repairs. Al's Robo Shack. It's Quarktastic!
Do you know what this means?
Yeah, Captain Quark is really sold out.
No, it means Captain Quark is on the top of us. We could tell him about this invasion.
If we had a ship.
What? A ship? What? You're not going to torture me? Well, as planetary chairman, I could arrange for you to borrow our courier ship. Cool.
You can count on us, sir.
No, Angel, no, no.
Thank you, your chairman shipliness.
I can never decide what the volume should be at. I'll just leave it at this. Hi, Angel. What do you want from me? Alright. Let's get everything we can around here, though, first. Oh, for a second I thought it said I had 27,000 volts. No. Sweet, I have 2,880. Yeah! Remember from this game is Ratchet becoming a major douche towards Clank. And I don't see why that's exactly necessary. There are a lot of things I remember about this game. Although some details are kind of vague. Oh. I don't know how to get back over. Here we go!
Hi there, Fuzzball.
Hey.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Oh, dirt. Now I'll come back here later. around. There's always something around here. Oh god. I do remember something being around here. And I think it was right down here. I know there was something right down there. If I could remember what. There's like a tunnel. Okay, there's like a tunnel underneath there somewhere. Actually, maybe I should just worry about sidetracks later. Yeah.
Excuse me, Captain, but we have more pressing issues. We urgently need your assistance.
Quark?
Yes?
Do you notice anything unusual about Captain Quark?
Well, I find the fact that he has a spring where his leg should be to be quite puzzling.
And why do you think that is?
Possibly an injury incurred while battling evil?
This isn't the real Captain Quark, you numbskull. It's a robot.
Oh.
You'd think Clank would recognize a robot when he saw one.
That's right, fitness fans. Just make it to the third island to claim your reward. And don't forget to tune in this week as I, Captain Quark, appear in person to present the grand prize for the Hoverboard Championship held in Blackwater City. Yes, you too can be as fit and good-looking as your hero, Captain Quark. Go ahead and take the challenge to see if you can claim the reward.
All right, let's take it. These are explosive, by the way. Two, three, four. Okay, so they explode after 3 seconds. There are actually achievements, by the way, about in this game, or I think in other games. I can't quite recall. There are some rather annoying ones, though. Like, in the second one. There was an obstacle course you had to somehow complete in, like, a ridiculous record time. Now, I'm only going to go after the achievements that are actually doable and not ones that are going to cause me excruciating irritation. Believe me, just because the achievements are difficult doesn't mean it's not my favorite game, but it's not my favorite pastime either to be earning such achievements. Okay, how the heck do I turn the camera? I can center. I can center the camera. Oh god. That's actually very good to know. Okay, so pressing down on the right analog stick shows the map and task. Oh god. Hold on, let me fix the camera. That's better. So yeah, notice how you can't really... So, the double jump doesn't really feature as, like, gaining extra air. But more like buying an a half second, extra second of time in order to do something you want to do. Which can be quite troublesome depending on what you're trying to do. Or it can also be convenient. It all depends on how well you use the double jump technique. It's actually very handy to know I can change it, change the camera. Maybe that's what it meant when it said,
Listen up, you loud balls! That was the most pathetic display I have ever seen on that obstacle course!
What do you mean?
We finished the circuit, ma'am.
Oh, no, but you're weak!
Then I must
continue.
If it were up to me,
you would drill for the rest of the day.
But somehow you managed to impress that fool Captain Quark.
Captain Quark knows about us?
He certainly does. And worst of all, he wants me to give you a prize for that ridiculous performance.
Cool, what is it?
I'm supposed to give you a steaming shot, so you can stay to and fro like little insects.
All right, let's see.
Not so fast. Today, the two of you disgraced my obstacle course, so I am going to make you pay!
But that prize is ours from the captain. That's not fair.
Too bad. Life's not fair.
I don't like you.
Sweet. I bet Captain Quark uses stuff like this all the time.
Ha! Real men can sing without silly toys like that!
The two of you make me sick! Oh, I completely forgot I could do this. Alright. Angel! No! Stop it! Stop rubbing on that! You're gonna mess up the camera. She wanted attention. I think there's an achievement you can get for destroying this. Oh wait, what if I use the bomb gun? Nope. Why is it not doing anything? Maybe I can't destroy it yet. So, I'll probably have to like... I don't know, I'll probably find like a better gadget or something. It's kinda cute how Clank hangs onto my back. How is he even doing that? What? Stop it. Hold on, I gotta give my little kitty attention. It helped. Eat on that. Stop it! I already gave you attention, stop being so needy. Hold on, I gotta get my book back. Well. I guess I can't hit him from here. Oh god. He almost knocked me off. Angel. Then move. She always gets in the way when I'm trying to record. Are you kidding me? Yeah, that's what you could get. Hell, bad dog. You're not the brightest man. What the hell? Oh, those are landmines. I didn't even see those. So yeah, you can only really talk to him at certain times. That is really handy. Yeah, it's only in Ratchet and Clank games 2 and 3 where you actually get, like, achievements. Later. I can just hold the button, right? Later. Darn it! Angel! Stop messing with the camera! My God. Alright, we're good. Hopefully. I don't know how long we're good for. think that was coming from? Wait, there was a nanotech crate right there. I could have used that. I know for a fact I did not collect that last time. Oh my gosh, I almost hit that. I think I'm stuck down here. Myself? Okay, no, I didn't. I'd love to. That would suck if I trapped myself. And all those little nuts and bolts are still there. How nice that they don't disappear, disappear after being left alone for a while. I don't need it. I don't need it. I need it! Are like rare collectibles in this game. They're hidden very well throughout the game. And I could go destroy Matt. Now I'm gonna sick him. I think there's like 40 gold bolts, well hidden, and they unlock weapons that are, let's just say they cost an ass load of bolts to upgrade, but they are well worth the upgrade. Oh God, what have I done? I do not mean to do this. There's an infobot back there. So note to self, do not long jump. How? Mine! Oh my god, I almost fell off. Wait, don't run away! I need you! Oh my god! Oh my god, I was so close to stepping on one! Oh my god, my butt clenched for a second. Can you stop throwing those? Like, seriously, dude. It's not cool. Wait, what's over here? Thankfully, these only go off once you actually walk on them. Wow, I must have some skill to actually throw through the grate and not where I wanted it to go. Yeah, I think that's where we were last time. So now we're up here.
Greetings, Executive Chairman Grant. It's thanks to the pleasantries, Lieutenant. My sources tell me you're behind schedule. You must prepare this planet to be harvested for our new world.
Yes, sir. As you can see, everything is moving along. That's fine.
I'm counting on you. As your former commander can tell you, I don't take disappointment well.
Yes, sir. I won't fail.
Drek is destroying yet another planet.
Yeah, but that's the kind of help he's getting. I don't think we have anything to worry about.
You should not underestimate Chairman Drek. He is quite dangerous. We must find Captain Quark.
Look, that lieutenant doesn't seem so tough. Let's take him out ourselves.
Perhaps we can persuade the lieutenant to tell us where Drek is.
Now you're talking.
So I'm going to end the episode off once I finish Planet Eudora. Actually, no. I'll end it off here, once I get out of this planet. Did someone die? Because I randomly... I heard... Hi.
Hi there, Fuzzball.
Blaster, Parasiter.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Oh, that's a nice one. Talks about bomb glove ammo. Very tempting, but I'm going to... This weapon really great for taking out those pesky small enemies.
That's a good move.
Pyrocider. This fearsome weapon really shines at close range.
Go, buddy. I ain't got all day.
Alright, fine. I'll Alright, till next time, everyone, when we go to planet Eudora, I think it was. And we are going to go and stop the planet from being harvested.